I gave myself 11 hours to create 2-minute short film just using AI. No camera, no crew, no high-end equipment, just my laptop and some of the most popular AI tools. In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how I did it from the very first idea till exporting the file. I'll walk you through the entire process, the tools that I have used, all the problems that I have faced and how I solved it. The goal was simple, but at first it felt impossible. Making a compelling, visually interesting 2-minute short film within 11 hours. This 11-hour time limit was not for any drama. It was a genuine test to see how far an indie creator can go with these AI tools. And the question was clear. Could all these AI tools come together and create something meaningful? Let's find out. Step 1. The script. I had a unique sci-fi concept. A scientist in the future have the ability to tap into any space-time coordinate. Basically, he can see what's happening at that time frame. He was trying to figure out what happened to the group of astronauts who were sent into space in different location, different space coordinates for a unique research. Light particles that have memory present near dying stars. The project was known as Project Luxora. But all these groups of astronauts and space researchers were missing. So the scientist invents the system of tapping into any time frame. He saw mummified bodies of those astronauts. Though they were mummified, he saw few bodies were moving. Astronauts who were still alive, begging for help. None of the team members believed what he saw. But at the end, he took a bold step. And that's the climax. I'm adding the entire film at the end of the video, and please do subscribe now. I gave the entire concept in ChatGPT. I was going for a narrator voice script for this short film. I spent almost 2 hours with ChatGPT to flesh out the entire script, and I kept giving feedback, and it was a to and fro process, and this was the final script. Step 2. The visuals. Creating the visuals to match the intensity of the script. The real challenge was character consistency, the visual consistency, and capturing the sci-fi, horror, and eerie tone throughout the film. And this was the character that I selected. I took a screenshot of the face of this character, and I used that as the only reference whenever I'm going to generate any scene where this character is present. And I really like this character. It perfectly fits our storyline because he is aged, have experience, and knows what he is doing, and even confident. And I also asked ChatGPT to visualize the entire script in different scenes and come up with MidJourney prompt. But the real problem with this is it's very limited, and you don't have enough of visual ideas to select from. So I went with the script line by line. Each line I tried to visualize something, and I wrote a prompt in MidJourney and start generating the visual. The first thing was art style. Dark, moody, cinematic, eerie, desaturated blue, and high contrast. And I will be able to alter few things in post-production. Then the lighting. Low-key, high contrast, and sci-fi looking color tone. Last but the most important thing is the camera lens. Sometimes I used keywords like anamorphic lens, shallow depth of field, and to get specific shots, I used extreme wide angle, close-up, macro. These are few keywords based on the visual that you want. I developed a base prompt for MidJourney to start developing different scenes. And the real challenge was visualizing the frames where the scientist is tapping into different time frame and seeing things what has happened. First visualization that came, some floating light around the scientist in his lab. The light is flowing in different directions, and I kept generating ideas based on this concept. I crafted this prompt multiple times in different ways in MidJourney itself. The more visual data you have, the better your visualization for the film will look. And in MidJourney, sometimes you can use --- chaos of value 5, so it will give a different variants of your ideas. Once I had all the selected still images, I used different tools to generate videos apart from MidJourney's video generation. Based on my research, I selected freepik. They provide all the most popular video generating models in one place. Mostly I use Runway, Kling 2.1, and sometimes I even used Kling 1.6. I used free version of Veo 2 in Google's AI Studio, but you will not be able to generate lot of video, but you can generate 4-5 videos per account login. So I always use the image to video generation. I explained the camera movement and the things that is going to happen inside that shot. In freepik, whenever you upload your first frame, it will automatically write a prompt for you. In general, mostly you will see the camera moving forward. You can change the camera direction and describe if anything specific you want apart from the prompt that is already written. It was a bonus to speed up the process. In MidJourney video generation, 80 to 90% I used high motion automatic. Entire prompt is already written, which helped MidJourney to generate that specific image. So it knows the context and you get 4 options for one single frame. The biggest advantage using MidJourney is you have different choice of selecting videos in any other model. Because the cost is so high, you cannot keep iterating multiple times if you are in a tight budget. In MidJourney, each video is for 5 seconds, but if you want to extend it, you just simply extend automatic high motion. It will just extend it to a 10 second video. So this entire film contains 80% MidJourney video generation. And in MidJourney, you can also add the frame as the first frame and describe your manual motion. You have that option. In total, around 50 to 60 videos were generated. Step 3, the audio. Now it's time to give the film a voice. I'm using ElevenLabs to bring the script to life. I chose ElevenLabs because it provides the widest range of different type of voices. The AI voice for any film is very crucial because it will set the mood, the tone, and the emotion of the film. I took the script and selected a voice that fits with our character.
This is Dr. Orion Thane, lead chrono observer at Polaris Singularity Lab.
The character is old, aged, experienced, have a deep voice. ElevenLabs also allows me to adjust the emotions. I can even emphasize pauses and certain words. It was done under 20 minutes. Step 4, the final assembling. I'm going to use Premiere Pro to assemble everything. I imported all the generated videos and the narration track. I played the entire narration few times. Wherever I felt a pause is needed, I gave a cut. There should be a breathing space for the viewers also. Once the rhythm is set for the entire film, I kept matching each visuals and kept placing on the track. It's like a jigsaw puzzle. Do not always keep the 5 second or 8 second videos. Sometimes use the 5 second tracks, and for few places use like 2 second, 1 second based on the beat and everything. So there will be a dynamic flow in the visual. It will not be boring. Then I kept adjusting the pacing for each shots. Once all the videos are placed and the pacing is all done, I added an adjustment layer with some color adjustment to give it your desired film look. You can use any LUT available. Do not overdo anything. I have added some film grain and I have lowered the opacity to 60-70%, and I added some ambient music, which is very important because it brings the drama and essence of the film. So I added some horror eerie tone with some clock ticking sounds. Whenever there is something very important, I added a riser. Do not overdo the sound design. Keep it simple, but just add few sound bites. So the entire film took me 12 hours to complete. And enjoy the film.
This is Dr. Orion Thane, lead chrono observer at Polaris Singularity Lab. Timestamp irrelevant, because time no longer matters. For decades, Earth lost contact with over 100 research crews. Highly trained astronauts, gone without trace. They weren't just on missions, they were part of Project Luxora. Luxora wasn't a place, it was a pursuit. A classified quantum experiment, trying to decode a phenomenon we called the light that thinks. An anomaly found near dying stars. A region where light doesn't behave, where photons linger, refuse to fade, as if memory is trapped in radiation. The missing astronauts were the first to study it. Then they vanished. No comms, no debris, no death signal, just silence. I was the only one mad enough to stay on it. I developed a system called Temporal Phase Tap. It let me view any frame of time in deep space, like skipping film reels. I thought I'd find answers. What I found was hundreds of them, frozen in their final moments. Astronauts, mummified inside torn EVA suits, skeletons slumped in command chairs, blood on cracked visors, each in a different ship, different star system. But one thing was always the same, the Luxora beacon, a shimmering pulse in the distance, like a second sun that no ship ever reached. I recorded everything, but then I saw something I can't explain. One of the bodies moved, its helmet shattered, its lungs should be dust, but it turned its head and looked right at me, through a time stream. They're not dead, or maybe they are, and something is wearing them. I ran another tap sequence, found an astronaut crawling toward his shattered console. He was alive, drenched in blood, whispering into a dead mic. It wants to be remembered. Another was scribbling a phrase into the frost on a cracked bulkhead, over and over. The light never forgets. My team doesn't believe me, but I'm going to do something reckless. I've locked my lab into continuous temporal drift. I'm not just going to watch anymore. I'm going in. If I don't come back, burn the tapes, destroy this technology, and for the love of humanity, never follow the light.